in the beginning, it was just too hectic to think about myself. But then when my daughters all got in school and I had this time to myself, I thought, gosh, I would really like to be part of the space program.
I was the youngest guy by far, 17 years old, and I didn't know A from Z, but they were willing to teach me. It was special. They cared about whether I was going to be successful or not.
We had this tremendous job that the president had asked us to do within a relatively short period of time. When I arrived at Kennedy Space Center, the vehicle assembly building was nothing but steel sticking up out of the sand. They were building the three launch umbilical towers.
The launch control center was a part of it. The launch pads themselves, 50 feet above sea level, underneath a whole catacomb of wires and piping. It's a little city out there.
There were 30,000 people working at Cape Kennedy. A lot of people came from big cities. They were used to nightclubs and adventures.
Out on the Cape, they would turn some of those roads into drag strips.
On Fridays, anyone that came into the mousetrap with their tie still on got it cut off.
All that's taking place at the same time you're trying to infuse this idea that everything we do is a life or death consequence. It better be perfect. It has to be perfect. And we aren't talking 5 or 10 pieces, we're talking hundreds of thousands of pieces and of people.
Lots of overtime, lots of time away from their spouses and families.
People altered their lives to do whatever was required to do to make Apollo happy.
And when you could see the pieces come together, it was pretty astounding. We're going to put men on the moon and return them.
I don't think this country has ever seen a program quite like Apollo. It was so broad and it touched so many people. And somehow that attitude of we can do it and I'm a part of the team, that got infused everywhere.
What made it so successful are the people. I know I wasn't an engineer, but I was a witness. I think it's the greatest technological team that's ever been formed.